A. Kumar was you came among the students. Of course, more importantly, youngsters. Sika, in particular, seated next to me here. Ramya, another student who is copying. All the learning teachers, my dear students. Next 30 minutes, I promise you'll never forget your life. As they say, they called me 5 years or 6 years. I think I've been coming almost every year. The CDE department always called me to inaugurate. I'm an engineer. But I call myself, with all humility, a human engineer. And I want to say the students here that, you know, we say the world always is undying, unquenchable, unshakable, and unstoppable optimism. I'm a chronic optimist. I believe till this end of the century we can prolong the life of this planet. That's all I can tell you. We got to serve as expert and based at the Government of India. We also came to Copenhagen, sir, right? They all spent 2 days that we will have no food by another 10 years. Cannibalism will get revived. This is all the shocking news. You are anxious. You are going to. Don't consider this just a ritual. Take it to heart. In fact, I like one of my own quotes, which I want to share with you. Now you have to decide whether I live up to my quote. The quote says, stop preaching, start doing. The world will be less by one scoundrel, at least you. So all of us good in preaching, we seldom practice. I took a decision long ago. I'm not Mahatma Gandhi. I don't wish to be Mahatma Gandhi for fear of being shot dead. So what I try to do, invariably, live up to my own promises. So this is what I've been doing. In fact, I told our respected dean and staff advisor, I asked them to come to my flat. In fact, it was Jay Kumar, Srikanth, all were there in my flat. I live only in a flat. In the flat, why? The greatness about the flat. You know, I grew up in a very rich family once upon a time. We lost everything and the fate was we should move to a flat. We own so much lands, we don't have land. So, I didn't give up. I became a farmer inside my flat. Can you believe that? I'm a farmer inside my flat. I grew up with me. You know, my wife is a doctor, the most tolerant woman than the mother here. She was a dean of director of General Hospital. My dad, 9 years old, yesterday celebrated his birthday. We are a cook, we are a nurse. We are, you know, I'm very such a socialist. I given a cabin and a TV for. I'm not criticizing you. The point is, I don't have mosquito. What the 2000 indicate? You believe it or not, I have 2000 real plants for, you know, living, I mean, inside my flat. All very healthy, healthily growing, all tools of plants. And my balcony is called Flower Shower. I think Srikanth, you saw it, right? Okay, wow, there is most learning English. And my balcony is called Green Pharmacy. My living room, I call it as what you call natural oxygen parlor. Your NIST students and police on the board. They came to the conclusion, Coimbatore is one highly polluted area and my flat, Arigan, is still more polluted. But you won't believe, they said, there is zero pollution in my flat. No pollution at all. So, it is within your control. What I want to tell you, all of you, listen to me. You don't need to go and do anywhere else. You don't need to, you know, you don't go and take a broomstick and go and sweep in a slum. Don't do that. Because I did that 20 years ago. We all went and when we swept, one man, people are watching us. Then they called us. I thought they were going to give their name. They said, we come next week also. That's what they asked us. 200 nation leaders came. 200 nation leaders came. Normally, any conference, agree in future, agree to resign. Nothing happened. Abruptly attended. Obama attended, Manmohan Singh, everybody attended. 20,000 people world over, you know, over like whole analysis campus. I'm right, Dr. Arun. They put such a huge building structure. Whole analysis, put it, what will happen? It's a town itself. They created thing and there was heating machine. It was very bitter cold. But what I did was, I gave a small diary and pen. When people are worried about the carbon footprint that we are all creating, I was calculating the carbon footprint that the conference was creating. Get the point? The conference was meaningless. Rio de Janeiro, same thing happened. It became the best dumping ground of garbage. The garbage remained for years after they conducted the conference in Rio de Janeiro. So the point is, whatever we do, it has to pay off Mother Earth. I tell in all my meetings, we call her Mother Earth because she uses oxygen. But what we do in return, we give her carbon dioxide. She uses food, we give her garbage. She is water, we give her sewage. She is rain, we give her acid rain. She is jungles, we give her concrete jungle. She gives petrol, we give her plastic. She gives chemical, we give her chemical waste. There are 200 things she gives, we do the opposite. But she gives gold to visual ourselves, to ornament ourselves. But we disfigure her by bombarding her. Don't you know that we are not there without her? I will be looking for a model which will model. And who will teach us? So I call mother here. Then I was looking for a brother or sister. He said, can I keep your hand? Keep your hand like this. What is that? What do you have in your hand? What's that you are in your hand? Those who are going to get married, chatty pond. Or a sportsman say, it's a planet, mother here. Mother here. You say that, mother here? Come on, repeat. Mother here. You have been kind to us. You have been giving everything. But we didn't realize its importance. We have been looking for a model. Now keep your hand like this, okay? And the model is brother. Next one of people here. I want you to make some value addition to yourself. I request you to kindly learn. You can learn from us because we are practitioners. You can learn waste minimization. You can learn conservation. You can learn energy saving. You can convert waste into wealth. You know one of our slogans, waste is not waste until it's wasted. It's not waste management, wealth management. Don't transfer waste, transform waste. Like that, you got 40-50 slogans. I don't have time to tell you all that. But it's enough you understand that resource management. If you understand that, the point is, you can learn rainwater harvesting. If you ask solid waste management, we tell you, we teach you source solid waste management. We teach you source rainwater harvesting, decentralized. Everything is compartmentalized. I want to tell you quickly some of our projects. The project one, in fact, I became a Buddha when my grandfather, father lost all our huge wealth. I can tell you honestly, I don't know, you figure out the 5 topmost richest person of Tamil Nadu, and our wealth was more than what they had. I mean, but fortunately, my father and grandfather gave me a different wealth. They did not give money, but they, what they gave me made me to acquire some knowledge. Recently, I addressed US Congress on Tamil Eelam last year, and I convinced the American government why Tamil Eelam should be there. I'm very happy, proud to say. And the point is, this all I got it because thanks to my grandfather and father, we lost our wealth, but I got some other wealth. I am compensated. So we had 550 acres land, grandfather. Father had 50 acres land. When his youngster, like my father, gave me 15 lakhs debts, the fate was I must buy a house in a slum area. As my mother wanted, a Jewish power. Mother cannot be there everywhere. The secreted God. My mother said, find a house in phone house. I said, Mom, how is it possible? Already I have 15 lakh debts. You try. I only gave me 40,000 rupees loan in 1971. I bought a house in a slum area. And I tell you, that's all was my turning point.